In the last episode, I introduced you to the switch statement, iterating over enum values. Today, I will further continue talking about the switch statement. I think I kind of promised you to talk about exception handling in this episode. However, I'm sorry, because I realized this topic is much bigger than I would have thought, so I would rather talk about exception handling in a dedicated session. So let's have this maybe a bit shorter today. And as always, let's recap what I showed you so far about the switch statement. So I told you that it's used to iterate over the different values of enums. Well, enums, which I also told you, were introduced with Java 5. Before that, the switch statement also existed, but you had to emulate enums. And the way this was done was by using int values. This is not so optimal, and this is also why enums were introduced, because they're more type safe. And I would also not recommend you to use ints in the switch statement. I think I already said that in the last episode. I even didn't want it to show you, but now I realized I think I should still show you, because you will see it sooner or later. And so that you can understand code of others, I will show you, but just try to avoid it. Okay, anyway, with that warning, I'll show you int. Now let's give it some name. I call it my state. And now I give it some number 42. I mean, this is just an example and could mean whatever. And this is already the problem. 42, what does it mean? Does it mean pending? Does it mean processed? How do we know? Well, to make it a bit better, they then introduced static final values, which I'll do right now also. So let's go to the top. And on the class level, let's introduce, no, this is a method, let's do it here, private static final, let's call it processed, I forgot to give it the type of the primitive type int, and this is the 42, and we could also have pending, so this is like a trick, sorry. But you see, this is also where enum values came from. So this is also why in enums we usually use the capital letters. Okay, because it's a constant value that will not be changed. So now I will give this the name of pending, and let's call this processing and processed. Now of course we need different values. That could be a 40, then this would be a 41, and this would be a 42. And now I can copy that, go back down, and then I can say my state, oops, equals pending. And pending now, I think it was 41. And then I can now switch on the int, and now this is funny, before the pending was of the logging level, but Java is smart enough to realize now we're not iterating on the enum anymore, but on the int, and as we also have processed there, as we have named it, it still works. Of course, I mean, just to show you, this is just because we named the variable, so if we, processing is not used, call this something, Then, of course, we will have to use this something below here, because now you see pending is red, because cannot resolve symbol pending, because we are not on the enum anymore, we are on the int something. The problem is that my state is an int, so no one guarantees us that only these three values that we want to use are used. Anyone at any time could say my state equals to 300, and then it would not be something, it would not be processed, it would end up in the default. See, and this is also a reason why here you should not have regular code, but throw an exception instead, which we'll talk about very soon, I hope. Okay, so anyway, this is what you can do with an int. And since Java 7, I mean, at the time I'm doing this video, we have Java 8. So when they introduce Java 7, you now can also use strings. My string. Give it a name. Call it also my string. Okay, not used yet. I copy it. And now we can also switch on strings. Of course, something doesn't work because it's not a string, it's an int. So now I can, of course, directly use, well, for example, the empty string or a blank string. I can use, again, something in lowercase letters. And of course, here also I can do, I call them labels, which then, of course, are private static final string. And now I call it, I don't know, I haven't used pending because here I've changed it to something. And I will call this pending. But it could also be anything, any string. 42, yeah, whatever. So of course, using that label, I'm only using one now. I think you got the point. Oh, I'm too far. Okay, so now with that label, I can also use pending in here. You might remember from the last session, I talked about the fall through, which is you don't have a break statement here. So if it's this case statement will be the same one as that statement, which will both then call this method, and then break is called, which will leave the switch statement, so the code will continue on line 122. The default is at the end. It could also, by the way, be anywhere else, for example, at the top, which would now be also a fall through. So if it's not pending or something, well, pending is, I don't even know anymore what we put there. I think it was 42. So in this case, all the three different cases would call a method, which here we could have some other method. As always, I'm not going to implement the method. And then we could say break, so that for the default, just this method would be called, and then we would end up here, leaving the statement and ending in, wait, where's the, see, if I put my cursor at the beginning of the switch statement of the curly brace, I directly see it ends up here, because if you have a method, and this is also a reason why you should keep your methods very short, you see the method seems to go until line 141, and this method now got so big that it's really hard to see where it starts and where it ends. So yeah, I can't say it often enough, keep your methods short. I would really keep them at 1 to 10 lines at most. I'm really happy if I'm able to keep them at 1 to 3 lines. Some say I'm really, I might be too strict on that, but you will very soon see the shorter your methods are, the easier it is to understand them, and also the easier it will be to reuse them. Yeah. Okay, but now back to the topic of the switch statement. So you can use it with strings as of Java 7. You can use it with enums, like I showed you in the last episode. You can use it with ints and any other number types. So far, I've only showed you int. Actually, there are others. I'm not sure if I should really talk about the others because they're hardly ever used. They're just the range of the number range is just a bit smaller. In 99% of the cases, you would use int because, I mean, it doesn't really matter these days how large the range is. So int is always fine. I mean, but maybe I still show you. For example, this could be a byte, but now this is already not working anymore. Why is it? Ah, because I have changed it on the string. Let's fix that. So the byte here, this is just smaller than the int. For example, if you put 3000 here, it says this is incompatible because it's an int, because it's too small. Yeah, but the 3 works. But I really don't want to go further in details. If you're interested, you can also read this on the internet, because all you really need in code in 99% of the cases is the int. So, okay. I think this pretty much rounds up the switch statement. So you can use it with a string and an int. Oh, there's one data type which I might show you. That's also interesting, and this is a car. A car is a string of a length of 1. Well, it's not a string, but it's very similar. So it uses these single quotes instead of the double quotes. So if I'm using the double quotes, it's automatically a string, and this doesn't work anymore. Here it says incompatible types required car found string. With a single quote, it's a car. So it's a character of length 1, one single character. Of course, it could also be A or B, but it cannot be longer than one character, because then it's not a character anymore. Too many characters in character literal. Okay, so we can also iterate over characters. This sometimes might be interesting. If you, for example, parsing a string, well, what is parsing? It's you have a string, my string equals something, and now you can take each single character, because a string is actually a combination of several characters, and then you can iterate over each character. And then you can switch over this. Yeah, this you might need at a later time. So I've also introduced car now and told you there are other number types. And yeah, that's pretty much it for the switch statement. So thank you for watching and see you next time.